Buenos días, mi gente. Welcome to La Primera Vez. I'm your host, Christina Reed, and this is the digital talk show that gives you the chance to get to know your favorite Latinx celebrities and entertainers. And today we are joined by actress, host, beauty influencer, everything in between, Miss Julissa B. Thank you so much for being here with us today.
Christina, thanks for having me. This is fun already.
We first obviously want to talk about how you even got here. We know that you were born in the DR. What was it like growing up there, and when did you come to the States?
So I was born in Dominican Republic. I was born in Santo Domingo. My parents moved us to Queens, New York when I was 2 years old. I mean, apenas tenía dos años cuando nos mudamos. And I basically ended up growing up in Queens, but I would go back, like most Dominicans, I think, go back and forth. At least the ones that I know that lived in New York, they go back and forth every single time that summer comes around. You know, you're booking that flight or around the, you know, holidays. But I feel like I really didn't get to know Dominican Republic until now, becoming an adult. And because, you know, when you're younger and you go, your parents, it's like they just want to take you from one tia's house to the next tia's house, and you're just like, I want to do something fun. Llévame para la playa, you know.
I know. And then instead they strip you off for the summer, and you're like, why am I doing hard labor? Like, what is going on?
Oh, the hard labor came from me early on because I have three older brothers and they always sent me to do everything. So I knew hard labor since I could, you know, get paid a dollar to go get them whatever they wanted from the fridge because they were too busy playing with whatever, you know,
whatever video game you got.
So that was definitely the case for me. And yeah, just going back and forth. And like I say, now as an adult, I really get a chance to go back and experience Dominican Republic in a way that I think the memories that I made when I was younger, that I can mix them now with my adult memories. And I have obviously way more freedom because I'm older now and I can come and go as I please. And, yeah. You know, I love to actually show that journey. And really I go back a lot because my parents retired and they live in Santo Domingo. So I get a chance to experience it with them in a different way too. And now that they're retired, I could be the sort of tour guide for them because I, you know, tell them, all right, let's do this adventure today, or I'm going to go for the holidays. So I like to take them to the things that they're not doing because they live there. They're not going to the all-inclusives and to the touristy things that I force them to kind of do, which is crazy because growing up in New York, I literally haven't done half of the touristy things that I feel like people that go to New York for. Just growing up in New York and really falling in love with the arts and, you know, having the dream of wanting to be on Broadway because I would go to Times Square and like the Great White Way. But that sort of led me to, and also having the ability and the privilege to be able to audition for different schools in New York, you're allowed to do that. And for me, it was all about the arts. So I went to a performing arts high school where I studied drama and theater arts. And then that's where I thought that was it for me. That's all I want to do. And of course, you know, you get into the business and then things change, goals change. And that's sort of what happened with me. A lot of people, they know me mainly from being a TV host and starting off on Mundos, which was a bilingual network that NBC and Telemundo merged and decided they wanted to cater to, I think, Latinas like us, where our first language was Spanish. But growing up in the States, you're kind of forced to obviously learn English, and then that's all you want to speak because now you have an accent and now people are making fun of you because you have this accent. So it's a never ending like ping pong of, you know, what do I do with this information? Because it's like, I obviously want to hold on to my culture as much as possible.
What you've just described is so beautiful. It feels like we're always in a state of like either translating in our minds, whether it's going from English to Spanish or Spanish to English again, but that like gives us that extra oomph, that extra, that layer, that flavor that helps make all of this so interesting and unique. Like, we're definitely seeing a boom right now in media where so much more representation is out there that it's really heartwarming to see. And then it also reminds us that we still have a lot more work to do as well.
So it is nice to see where the progression has brought us to. I still obviously think that we can do way better when it comes to representation.
Right.
But, you know, we're moving forward, and that's all that matters. Forward.
That was totally me in high school, my parents speaking to me in Spanish and me answering them in English. And then there was a moment where my Spanish got a little ratatata and
yeah.
I had to really get it back. Yep, like Cardi B said. Oh. And it was muy ratatata at one point, but I had to reel it in and we're back on track now. But I know my parents were worried in high school. They're like, I mean, niña, like, what are we going to do with her?
Oh, girl, to me, till this day, especially doing interviews in Spanish, all of a sudden I forget anything I ever learned. All of a sudden I can't think of words because you're thinking now in another language, but then you're also, it's just a lot. I mean, you get it. And I think most Latinos in this country that grew up in a similar setting, they understand. But, you know, I always say, yo me defiendo, and that's what happened. And that's all.
And that's that. And we leave it at that. Mm-hmm. So you mentioned loving Broadway when you were younger, Times Square, performing art school. Throughout that progression of you realizing like arts and entertainment is something that you wanted to pursue, what was that transition like? What was your first big break in the entertainment industry?
It really happened when I started auditioning and my very first job ever was a Wendy's commercial. And that's how I got, my SAG card. That's how I became union.
Wow.
And mind before that, I actually ended up going to a cousin of mine's Sweet 16. And I had another cousin there. And mind you, these are cousins that I'm meeting for the first time when I was younger. And my mom's like, Jerónimo, háblale a Julissa de negocio porque él es un actor. So I had a cousin of mine that was like doing just gigs. He was really putting himself out there to be an actor. So he just gave me a contact that he had of a manager out in Long Island. So I sent her my pictures. Then she sent me on auditions. And one of the things that I booked was a Wendy's commercial. And then it kind of snowballed from there. And then I started auditioning for a bunch of other stuff. And one of the things was Mundo. So then I booked that. And literally it just started snowballing. And it's something that I fell in love with. And then BET. And then MTV, and then we did Empire Girls. And when I think about it now, it's just like crazy because time literally flies. And just sort of the resources that you have now to put yourself out there versus when I first started, it was all about you go in, you audition. If they like you, you get a callback. If you get the callback, then you get the producer session. If they like you, you get the job. It was like so many steps before you get this one job. And now it's about numbers and social media and, you know, if you became a viral sensation. So I always say like, I would always, if I had a crystal ball or if I could rewind and see what it would be like nowadays starting off, I wish I could have that insight, but obviously I think timing of everything and just like keeping it going and one goal breeds the next. So of course you book one job and one opportunity and then that just starts ramping you up for the next thing. And it's wild to even just be interviewed, you know, by Latina Magazine. And, you know, I remember going to you guys' office and you know, in New York, and it's like, oh my God, I'm taking the train to go into the city before it was to go to high school. And now I'm like in the city going to, you know, meet with publications like Latina and all the other things. So it's kind of been a crazy ride.
Everybody has that like first gig that like, you know, really helps shape who they are. Like a Wendy's commercial to now, like where you are, that's so major and so incredible. And I'm sure that's gonna be really inspiring for our viewers who especially are looking to get into the entertainment industry. You never know where you're gonna start or, you know, who you run into at a Sweet 16 that could, you know, kind of kick all of it into gear. So that is a really impressive story for sure. So from one host to another, what is it that you love so much about hosting?
I think the people you meet and the stories that you get to tell in the process is definitely one of my favorite things.
Can you take us through a day in the life of a host from your perspective?
You know, figuring out if there's interviews that day, you usually have production calls, you run through whatever the interviews are with your producers, you wanna make sure you're as prepared as possible, you wanna do your research on whoever it is that is interviewing you, or you're interviewing, because you want to be able to have that interview stand out as much as possible. Obviously, there are certain things. If they're promoting a project, you make sure you ask the questions about the project, because that's, in their mind, that's what they're there for. But if you can also get the other nuggets and tidbits that are going to be clickable, that are going to be things that make for great sound bites, it's kind of like you always have that in the back of your mind as a host. Then once you go through production, you get yourself ready. And then it's, if you're on set, every day is different, because energetically, that's just the case. You know, you always want to have as much energy as possible. I'll never forget, I mean, from when I auditioned for my very first hosting job, I didn't know what I was doing. I mean, half the time I was looking in the wrong camera. But I just thought to myself, if I bring energy, that's going to translate, and people at home hopefully will feel that.
It definitely translates. You are always such a light to look at. And in doing my research and like preparation for this interview, I'm always so blown away by like how you can just command a space. That's always something I'm working on. So your hard work does not go unnoticed.
Seriously, thank you. You gotta own it, girl. The minute you walk in, you have to remember, and I think it was Will Smith that said it, you can't have the room feel like it's bigger than you.
As you've been transitioning from hosting and acting, and now you're transitioning more into the beauty space, what can you tell us about República Skin? You know, this is a really big deal, a super big venture. We're so excited about it.
Thank you so much. Well, yes, it is definitely the first time I'm stepping into a role of straight up entrepreneurship. When I say that, I mean where I don't physically have to show up somewhere holding a microphone and being the host, being present, whatever that is, or having to literally do a job or a tutorial or whatever that is. This is a brand that I'm starting that I've inspired by my upbringing, and it's sort of an homage to where I was born and in the discovery of getting to know República Dominicana, and that's where the name is derived from. So República Skin, it is definitely inspired by the beauty of Dominican Republic. And one of the beauties of Dominican Republic is that we are known for having one of the most natural resources of sugarcane. So I started playing around with that idea, and then just remembering like my trips to Dominican Republic and then back to New York, and the back and forth of it all, and how my skin would look and feel when I'm in the Caribbean and when I'm in Santo Domingo and when I'm in the beaches of Dominican Republic, glowy, dewy, hydrated, awesomeness. Then I go to New York and I'm like dry, flaky, ashy, trying to hang on to all the things to look like I'm still in Dominican Republic. So the wheels started turning in my head, and then I just started literally DIYing, and I thought, okay, well, you know, sugarcane is something that we have a lot of as a natural resource in Dominican Republic, so it's going to be a sugar-based product. So then I started playing around with that idea, and then I also started doing my research on that and like how that is kind of controversial even in Dominican Republic. And I'm like, okay, so I need to have the charitable aspect as well, because especially nowadays, you know, where people, a lot of the farming industry, unfortunately, you know, got overlooked, or people didn't think about, you know, what those jobs look like during a pandemic. And even prior to the pandemic, how tough it is. If I can find a way to merge the love of my country that I was born in with the love and passion of beauty, and also having that element of giving back, then I think I'm onto something. And that's what República Skin is.
Just to hear like the thought process behind it, the inspiration is so like, that's so heartwarming to hear.
It's a sugar body polish. So essentially it's a sugar scrub. It's an exfoliant for your body. And that's gonna change the game, because there's so many benefits to sugar. It's a natural humectant. And then I mixed it with these other ingredients that I think really marry the goal of getting that nice glowing hydrated skin beautifully, with vitamin E, avocado oil, macadamia oil. Just really a nice mix that I think is gonna make you feel as if you are transported to the Caribbean and to Dominican Republic, but in the comfort of your own shower, I like to say.
I love that. That's good. My skin is—it's a little dull right now. So the moment the moment that I can support, I will definitely be, and my skin will thank you for it. I already know.
Oh my gosh, yes. I cannot wait for the world to try it. I've been working on the formulation for so long because let me tell you, if I've had pressure in my life of anything, is really when you put your name on something. And listen, an interview, people see it, it's old news, especially nowadays where things are moving at such a fast pace and are so instant. But when you put your name on a product, and I was not about to come out with no BS, like I refused, and all my friends are like, Julie, stop being such a perfectionist. I'm a Libra, and we are just, I guess only speak for myself, but I was not about to put myself out there. And when I've been literally in this influencer space and the beauty space, and people, I've given people advice and I've tried to sell them everybody else's stuff. Like, I'm not trying to sell you my product. I want you to want it. I want you to come back and get more of it and feel like, oh my gosh, let me tell a friend to tell a friend to tell my tia to tell my other tia. Like, it's all about word of mouth, and you also only get one shot at this.
That's beautiful. I think perfectionism gets a bad rep, and people are always like, don't be so hard on yourself, just put it out there. The important thing is that you started. I'm very much on your side where I'm all for putting myself out there, but like, I have to make sure it's like the damn best job that I could do, going along that notion of waiting for the right moment and making sure things that align, making sure that things do align for you. What advice do you have for young Latinas who are trying to break into the entertainment industry? What are their best ways to protect themselves while showcasing their cultures and, you know, trying to rise to the top?
Definitely authenticity. I truly believe in you're gonna be out there and you're gonna feel like, oh, I have to, I mean, even our conversation about an accent, you know, I did a whole, journey on Empire Girls about my accent because it was something that I kept getting, you know, feedback on or whatever. But like, at the end of the day, yes, you can modify. Yes, you can get better with things and all those notes that you're given, you know, you take them, you digest them, but you ultimately always want to stick to what makes you you. And nowadays, the way individuality is celebrated like it's never been before, I think it's beautiful. And ultimately, use that to your advantage. If you're going to be anybody, be you to the 1000%. And people that get you, they will embrace you, love you, and those that don't, they eventually will, because they will get it. And you just can't stop, you know. You nowadays, especially too, I talk like I'm such a vieja, but I do say
that. No viejas over here.
I've just seen the transition as far as the, you know, just the career transition of everything, you know, like where the industry is these days. When I say that, I mean, you know, use your resources. That's definitely another piece of advice that I would say. Use your resources. Get on the gram, get on TikTok, get on whatever it is that you can display your talents on, because you never know who's gonna see it. You never know what's gonna go viral. And literally, you have the freedom of that.
The way that you outlined that about just being yourself, that's truly the key. Putting on a persona can only get you so far. Being you, whether that's having an accent or, you know, being able to speak four different languages, that's what sets everybody apart from the next person. So I really
absolutely think that. I mean, that authenticity, like at the end of the day, everything's already been done. You're not reinventing the wheel. You're entering an oversaturated market no matter what it is. Everyone's doing it. It's how you're doing it, because no one is you, and that already makes you different.
What do you hope to get out of your future projects, whether that's with acting or hosting or with Republica Skin? What are you hoping to, you know, make a mark on, and what are you hoping for your fans to receive?
Well, with Republica Skin particularly, again, it goes back to that authenticity of having people recognize that this is something that was made out of labor of love. I don't have a famous last name. I didn't grow up with a famous last name. I didn't have maybe, you know, some resources that I don't know, maybe accelerated other people and that helped them to their advantage. All I can do is control what I have and what I've done and what I can put in hard work towards. And that's really what I would love to leave behind as far as a legacy, as far as anything that when my name is attached or spoken in rooms, I want people to say, man, you know, she did it. She gave it her all, that's for sure. And that's something that people can't take away from you. And with República Skin, you know, it goes back to just even the curation of it all, the idea of it all. I want to be able to put a product out there that I'm super proud of, that people can also say, wow, you know, she found a way to sort of pay homage to where she was born. Instead of going out and buying, you know, maybe that dream house, I'm like, you know what? Maybe República Skin is going to be the thing that gets me that dream house. I don't know, but at the end of the day, I'm only going to be this age once. You only live once. And I know that if I can put something out there that I worked really hard on making sure that it was great, and if the rest of the world can receive it and think it's great too, then I've done my job.
Así mismo, just like that.
If anything else, I'm going to end up having to get a product for hair loss. I'm going to be pressed. You know what I mean? Like, I have to just, I can only control what I can control.
And you, from what we can see, from what I can see, you seem to be doing it really flawlessly. I will say that.
Thanks.
I'm sure there are bumps in the road behind the scenes, but you are such an inspiration. And I feel like all of our viewers are really going to resonate with all the gems that you've dropped, you know, these messages of authenticity and putting your best foot forward, but also like taking a chance on yourself. You know, sometimes we can go the safe route and, you know, do the things that are expected of us. And sometimes we can, you know, put ourselves out there and get a big reward out of it. So I really appreciate you sharing all of that with us.
During the pandemic, I actually was so blessed and fortunate enough to meet my mentor, who really showed me along the way of product production and formulation and a lot of the things that I was basically taking that DIY and at home, all the things that were going wrong, helping me figure out, well, why isn't this formula working? If I did this and this and this, and, you know, doing the research and just the knowledge, you know. Sometimes people come into your life for a reason, and I'm so, so thankful to have a mentor that I never thought in a million years that I would have a mentor, and it's been one of the biggest blessings of my life.
Shout out to the mentors everywhere who help guide us on our paths and help us find the answers that we didn't even know were possible.
So. Now I have to find a way to pay that forward, because eventually one day I want to be able to mentor somebody or just, you know, hopefully they are inspired by a conversation like this.
Well, let me know if you need a mentee, because we can talk.
This is about to put on a lab coat and go with me to the lab and figure out something.
Hey, I'll get some gloves. I'll bring the goggles. I'll be ready. I can take notes. Whatever you need, let me know. Throughout the beginning of your career to now, and where you envision it going so far, what has been the most full circle moment that has really made it clear to you that you're on the right path and, you know, what you're working towards is worth it?
Yeah, I mean, there's quite a few for me. If we're gonna talk about the industry and the business of it all, I would say actually driving on to the set of a job that I've been to that same lot or that same security guard before, and it was to audition and then not get the job. So I think those moments definitely resonate, and I'm like, wow, this is full circle. Now I not only got the job, but I have my own ID card, and yes, I'm here. I am actually here, hired for the show. I am allowed to be on this set right now. Those are definitely moments that I never take for granted, and that are always full circle for me. Or anytime, honestly, anytime I see my name, like in a green room, you know, on a production call, or you know, just those moments that, girl, they seem like so, they seem so far out of reach, right? And when you actually roll up and you're like, I'm here.
Right, I'm meant to be here, and my name is on the door and it's on the card and I'm supposed
to be here. And I'm allowed to be here.
Yep, so let me in, please.
And then also being inspired by women that I like to call multi-hyphenate hustlers, you know, people like Jennifer Lopez, someone like Daisy Fuentes, that was a full circle moment for me when I got a chance to work opposite Daisy Fuentes in South Africa to shoot a commercial. It was a Spanish commercial for Kohl's. And I remember vividly thinking, oh my goodness, I can't even believe I'm actually acting opposite Daisy Fuentes, who is a Latina TV host for MTV, the coolest. And then she flipped that and made a whole empire with a clothing line at Kohl's, with all the other things that she was able to do in the entrepreneurial space. So yeah, that's kind of like what I envision, you know, for my, you know, God willing, for myself with República Skin. One day I want to be able to have a full circle moment even with that and say, oh my goodness, I can't believe I was able to get my product in the hands of XYZ, you know, someone who I've never thought in a million years would even know that I exist.
I love that. I remember the Daisy Fuentes bra that my mom got me 1 year of high school you could not get me to change out of it. That was my favorite one. So when you mentioned that, I was like, no, that really is a full circle moment, because she built an entire empire and that does not go, I feel like that does not go appreciated enough. So
She DM'd me, and then I'll never forget when we met when we personally got invited, when I was doing Empire Girls, Adrian and I, we personally got invited to her fashion show during Fashion Week, during New York Fashion Week. And I was just like, oh my gosh, they sent a car to pick us up. It was a moment.
Yeah, no, that's that pinch me moment. Your answer was perfect, seriously. that's the full circle moment that people dream of. So thank you so much for sharing that with us.
Yeah, anytime. I mean, I have a whole vault of moments that I'm sure if I talk to you long enough, we'll just start spewing out. But for the sake of time and not being so long-winded, I'm sure I have been.
Well, thank you so much for being on La Primera Vez. We're so happy to have you. We can't wait to see all the beautiful things that come out of República Skin. And just thank you again. This was amazing.
Yeah, thank you. I'm sending you a virtual hug.
Virtual hug, gracias. Abrazos, besos, all of it. Hey. All of it. Bendiciones también.
Ay, gracias.
Bueno, te veo. Bye.